Matthew chapter 26. I'm going to begin reading verse number 36. The Bible says, "Then cometh Jesus with them unto the place called Gethsemane, and saith unto the disciples, Sit ye here while I go and pray yonder. And he took with him Peter and the two sons of Zebedee, and began to be sorrowful and very heavy. Then saith he unto them, My soul is exceeding sorrowful, even unto death. Tarry ye here, and watch with me. And he went a little farther, and he fell on his face and prayed, saying, O my Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as thou wilt. And he cometh unto his disciples, and findeth them asleep, and saith unto Peter, What, could ye not watch with me 1 hour? Watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. The spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak. He went again the second time and prayed, saying, O my Father, if this cup may not pass away from me, except I drink it, thy will be done. And he came and found them asleep again, for their eyes were heavy. And he left them, went away again, and prayed the third time, saying the same words. Then cometh he to his disciples and saith to them, Sleep on now, and take your rest. Behold, the hour is at hand that the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners." Let's pray. Father, we bless you. We thank you, Lord, that we can come out on this Wednesday night and worship you in spirit and in truth. We thank you for the Scriptures. We thank you for the house of God. We thank you for the people of God. We thank you, Lord, for the blessings of God. Daily you loadeth us with benefits. God, we thank you for the glorious light that shineth within us that came from thee. God, we're thankful that, Lord, we've been indwelt by the Spirit of God. God, we're thankful, Lord, that, Lord, as many will be driving down the highway, have no idea what is so important about being in church tonight. We come in knowing that, Lord, all is well in heaven, and then that is our final home. Now, Lord, as we come to you tonight, we're praying to the same Father that Jesus prayed to in the garden. Lord, it's a sobering thing to think you not only heard his prayers, you hear our prayers. And as we heard in camp meeting, the Lord Jesus himself is our mediator. And Lord, we bless you and thank you, Lord, that we can bring our petitions unto thee and you hear and answer prayer. Father, thank you for the good singing, the good time of fellowship leading up to church. Lord, I pray for Miss Mary. Lord, we know that this new tumor did not catch you by surprise. Lord, we know in order for it to get to her, it had to come through your hand, for she's in your hand, and your hand's in the Father's hand. God, we pray for Miss Mary. Lord, none of us know what a day brings forth. Lord, many of us plan on living many years, but we don't know what tomorrow brings. But Lord, we do have right now. And God, I pray for Miss Mary. I pray you'd strengthen her. I pray you'd encourage her. And God, we certainly pray for her son. You know what he stands in need of tonight. And God, we pray for her family. You'd comfort them and help them during these days. We pray for Miss Kathy as well. We know she'd be here if she could. Pray for Miss Vanessa the same. Lord, you touch her and help her. Lord, others that are sick, you touch them. Lord, those that are providentially hindered, you'd be with them. Lord, thank you for helping Brother Bob. It's good to see him back tonight. God, we pray that, Lord, you'd touch hearts tonight. We pray for that one that is seeking answers from God, that, Lord, tonight they'd find them in Christ. Father, I pray if there's any amongst us tonight lost without the Lord, Lord, I pray that, Lord, the sweet Holy Ghost of God would speak to their heart, show them their lost condition, and I pray we'd see them born again before it's everlasting too late. Father, I pray for somebody here, Lord, just struggling. Lord, you'd help them. God, whatever the need is, Lord, you know our down sitting, our uprising, the number of the hairs on our head. You know what each and every one of us stand in need of. And God, I pray thy will would be done. Now, Father, I certainly pray you'd be with Brother Brian and Miss Veronica and Brother Mike and Miss Kay as they get away, give them a good trip, bring them back to us safely. God, again, meet every need of every heart. We'll thank you for it. Use this unworthy vessel now, Father. Glorify your name. We'll bless you for it. For it's in the holy and wonderful name of the Lord Jesus we ask these things. Amen. And amen. In these verses, we find the night of the Lord Jesus' betrayal. He's about ready to go to Calvary and pay our sin debt. I'm glad he left glory, was born through the Virgin Mary, stepped out of glory into her womb, came forth into this world, robed in flesh, lived a sinless, perfect life, and went to the cross of Calvary, bled and died and paid our sin debt, was buried and rose again to according to the Scriptures, made a way where sinners could be saved from their sin, made a way where old Gentile dogs could be brought into the family of God, made a way, the choice vine of Israel, he grafted in a branch, the church, made a way where we could know him and worship him and have assurance of faith tonight. What a blessing for that. But we get to Gethsemane, and I look at this, and there's some things I want to share with you tonight. I want you to notice, first of all, the place. He's in a little garden, not too far from Calvary. This garden's called Gethsemane. Gethsemane means the place of the press. Can I say there was a wine press there where they would gather the grapes from the vineyard? They'd go to Gethsemane, and through that press, they'd get the fruit of the vine as they pressed those grapes. Can I say, my dear friends, at night, Jesus was pressed. The psalmist in Psalms 22 prophesying about some of the things Jesus would go through. He said, the bulls of Bashan, they encompass me. Another account of this in the Gospels, we find that his sweat became, as it were, great drops of blood. Can I say, in this place, this is where the devil tried to kill him. We know the devil didn't kill him on the cross. He laid down his life. He said, my Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit. And Jesus gave up the ghost. They didn't kill him on the cross. He gave his life for you and I. He didn't spill his blood. That implies an accident. He emptied himself of his blood to be the propitiation for our sin, to pay our sin debt. But if the devil could have killed him in the garden, my dear friends, the Bible wouldn't have been true. There'd been no hope for us. We find this place, the place of Gethsemane. I want you to notice his painfulness. Look at verse 38. The Bible says, into verse 7, 37, he's got Peter, James, and John with him, and he says, he began to be sorrowful and very heavy. Then he saith unto them, my soul is exceeding sorrowful even unto death. Can I say it was a painful place? Again, his sweat became, as it were, great drops of blood. Can I say this tonight? The Lord Jesus didn't take care of this body the way many people take their body. Take care of the body. He didn't rest it. Many times while the disciples were sleeping, he'd be up in the mountain praying. He didn't eat like it should be ate, three square meals a day. He ate when it was convenient for him. Many times, rather than take things to himself, he was taking nothing and feeding the multitudes because Jesus knew he was only going to need this body for a little while.
Did you know that you could receive a daily devotion every morning in your inbox? Head on over to ibcflorence.com and click on Daily Devotions to sign up today. And as always, thanks for listening.